John, a point taken from a hard-fought game in what looked like really, really difficult conditions in the air and underfoot. How tough was it this afternoon?
Difficult for both sides. You know what? The ref should be congratulated for getting the game finished. But it became a lottery, and I think it should have been called off at half-time. The ball was sticking, players were slipping all over the place. A 10-by-10 portion of the pitch was decommissioned. You know, that was a no-go area. And considering we had a game called off last Christmas because there was a 1-foot by 1-foot hard patch, and 1 foot, not 10 yards, 1 foot by 1 foot, and the rest of the ground was playable. So, you know, we've got two different sides of the coin. I think if their manager would have wanted the game off, it would have got called off at half-time, because I think the referee was leaning towards what I was saying. But I can understand their point of view, that they've travelled a long way. Half-time, they're in a clean sheet, that's 0-0, and they don't want to come back in on Tuesday. I can appreciate all that, but it wasn't conducive to be able to play proper football on it, because you couldn't run with the ball. And, you know, I think that's hampered us more than them.
It's been pretty ceaseless over 48 hours, the rain. Should it have started?
There's nothing wrong with starting the game, but you could see that the ball was stopping, and you couldn't physically run. If you got away from someone, you couldn't run because the ball was going to stick behind you. So it became there was some good football played, but some of it was farcical. And you know, I understand all this safety thing, and it's not so much a safety issue with me. It's more the fact that the spectacle of the game of football, and we believe our best chances of winning games is when the conditions are okay and you can pass the ball and run with the ball. And we opened them up first 10 or 15 minutes, and we were blighted, not so much by their defence but by the pitch. And you know, at the end, after all the dust settles, it probably won't be a bad point.
I was going to say, taking it all into account, are you happy with the performance and what you're taking away from it?
I'm not happy with the performance, because second half we got a bit disjointed, and you know, obviously the team going off didn't help, but we got a bit disjointed. We lost our way a little bit after starting the half really brightly. And if I'm truthful, the only team who was going to win in the last 5 minutes would have been Newport. So, you know, I don't bury my head in the sand, and I don't stick my chest out that much. I think if the conditions had been better, it would have favoured us and give us a better chance to win the game, but we're not going to blame that. You know, they had to deal with the same conditions as us, although I think it slightly favoured them. But, you know, with 10 minutes to go, I'd turn around and shook their manager and took the points, because I could only see them scoring.
You mentioned the injury to Dean Winard, obviously a big blow. How important was it in terms of the run of the game, because he was actually off the field, wasn't he, when you conceded?
Well, we should have organised ourselves better. We're trying to adjust, and have scored in that mini time when we got 10 men. You know, it's a minute and a half. And we should have organised ourselves better. And, you know, we'll have to learn from that for future reference. Good finish by the lad, but we think it could have been stopped. And we certainly think the second goal could have been stopped and should have been stopped. But, you know, we scored a couple of good goals ourselves with good moves. And we maybe should have scored a couple of others. You know, we had some glorious chances in the first half that we didn't take. And I think if we'd have took the lead, it might have been a different game.
Is it a mark of the expectation levels from what you've done so far this season, that you've scored twice, hit the post, forced a couple of good saves from their goalkeeper, and everybody's feeling a bit flat about it?
I'm not so flat. You know, there's a long way to go. Disappointed that a lot of teams have made ground on us. But there's a long way to go. There's a lot of football to be played. We have to learn from the experience that we've been through today. And it's happened two or three times where we've got ourselves pinned in a little bit. And we'll go through it with them on the training grounds and on the videos. And, you know, we play on the front foot with a much better team. And we got a little bit disjointed with the sections of defence, midfield and attack. And the attack got a little bit isolated today. Sporadically, we looked threatening, but not nowhere near enough like we should do in the second half. And as I say, we learn. You know, every day's a learning day. I'm learning every day. And, you know, that's sometimes when it gets a bit too easy, you have to go out and earn your money. And that has to be done on the training ground.
And you've spoken a lot about getting people through the turnstiles, just finally. 1,500 crowd today, only 100 visitors. Is that a bit of a green shoot, a sign of encouragement?
Oh, without a doubt, and I think the fans were really good today. They got behind us, made a lot more noise, and hopefully it'll go in the right direction. Anyway, it wasn't particularly a bad game to watch, but just from a professional point of view, you're always a bit disappointed when you haven't picked up 3 points at home.